by Kushwant Singh. You all know very well that every lesson we learn will have some or other moral that we carry for our life. You always, I'll say, you learn a lesson for two reasons. One, to gain knowledge. Two, to take some essence from that lesson to follow it in your life. So at the end of the lesson, I want you to realize what you are taking out from this lesson to follow in your life. Yes? Obviously, knowledge, you will gain it, and I'm going to teach you, you will gain it very well. So page number 1, unit 1, post lesson, The Portrait of the Lady by Kushwant Singh. Before we start up with the lesson, we will go ahead to see certain points about the author. Kushwant Singh is an Indian novelist and a lawyer. He studied at St. Stephen's College, Delhi and King's College, London. He joined the Indian Foreign Service in 1947. As a writer, he is best known for his keen secularism, sarcasm and love for poetry. So he is mostly interested in poetry, and he is also an Indian novelist, so you will know, you can easily connect with this author because he is again an Indian novelist who will always carry out the value of the family, how the family will run, how the relationships will be, because we Indians all over the world, all over the India, we Indians are similar in carrying our relationship, right? So we give most value to the family. Like the Kushwant Singh in his work also, he will carry most of the value for family. And he served as an editor for several literary and news magazines as well as two newspapers. Kushwant Singh was awarded with Padma Bhushan in 1974, Padma Vibhushan by Government of India, and Sahitya Academy Fellowship by Sahitya Academy of India. To name few of his famous works, The Mark of Vishnu. Mark of Vishnu was one of the prose lesson in standard 12. Very fantastic story, very nice story, enjoyable story. You can search it in the Google and you can read that story if you want, if you have time, if you love reading stories, if you like to know what this lesson is all about, or if you want to understand more about Kushwant Singh, you can just go ahead to download that PDF, or in the online also the reader will be available, you can read it. The History of Sikhs, Train to Pakistan, Success Mantra, We Indians, and Death at My Doorstep are some of his brilliant works. Most of the works have the Indian touch, so you can go ahead and enjoy his stories. Whenever you feel bored you feel like I'm at home, I don't have something else to do, whatever my school has given, I've finished, then you can go ahead to try these books. Try learning these books. Just download it from the Google, you will get it. Yes? Okay? So to proceed with the story. In the story, there are two main characters. Two people are there. One is the grandmother, the other is the grandchild. The story completely speaks about the relationship between the grandmother and the grandchild mostly. Okay? And as the days move on and on and on, what is the difference that is happening in the relationship between the grandmother and the grandchild? How the grandmother tackles that situation? How she engages herself? How she is becoming a better person even though she is aged, even though she is becoming older? How she is becoming a better person in her life? That is covered in this story. And before we go ahead with the lesson, I want to ask you two questions. Do you know what is a nuclear family? Of course you will know. Many of us are a nuclear family due to various other family situation. Yes. And if you are lucky enough to stay in a joint family with the grandmother, grandfather, all aunt, uncles, everybody, most of the people are in nuclear, but many are even lucky. Even today they are lucky to stay in a joint family. When you are in a nuclear family, when you are in a joint family, what is that difficulty you face? Jot down your points. Okay, in page number 1, there is a column given for nuclear family and joint family. I'll show you that. Okay, based on your opinion, you can fill in the column. The question asked is, based on your visions given above, there are two pictures given. One is a joint family, one is a nuclear family. Give five words or phrases to describe the two family types. So description need not be like there are four people, there are many people. There is father, mother, daughter, the son, there are more like grandfather and grandmother, not like that. I want you to specifically tell, because you are 11th standard, you are not 6th standard children who can just like that give the differences between the two pictures. I want you to pick out the emotions that the nuclear family and the joint family carry. Got it? For me, if you ask me, I would say nuclear family is like all the time father, mother has to engage the children. And if the father and mother has to work, they have to go out, children has to take care of themselves. These are all the negative points. Whereas positive way, always it is a short family, small family, we can share our happiness, togetherness in a more convinced manner. We can share our views very easily without others' interruption. Positives and negatives for nuclear family, I have told you. Joint family, yes, always there is a person who is there, who will be taking care of the children. Even the father, mother, whoever is working, they can have their own privacy, they can have their own time. They can have a conversation, a family conversation or discussion if they want to take some decision. All that can happen in a joint family. If I want to tell you about the negatives, negatives are less, where only the privacy thing matters. Everybody will be involved in your decision, you don't like it, you want to be on your own, will not be allowed. Okay? So certain things are there, negatives and the positives are there in nuclear family, negatives and positives are there in joint family too. So once you jot down these points, you will have to understand this lesson is not completely about now joint family or nuclear family, but the question I asked you to answer at the end of the lesson. What is that you are going to take after this lesson? After this lesson, what you are going to follow in your life? For that, this may help you. Have it in mind. So to start with, the lesson says, here is a story that brings out the bond between the author and his loving grandmother. My grandmother, who is telling this? The author is narrating. The author is acting as a narrator in this story. My grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, was an old woman. See how he starts. He is just telling you. The portrait of the lady means he is portraying, according to him, what is this lady? How is this lady? What is the visual he is carrying in his mind? He is just portraying about his grandmother in this story. That's the name, the portrait of the lady. Got it? So, my grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, was an old woman. He is starting it in a very simple manner. To you, your grandmother is an old woman. To me, my grandmother is an old woman. Like that. For him also, grandmother is an old woman. She has been old, wrinkled for 20 years that I had known her. People said that she had once been young and pretty and even had a husband. But that was hard to believe. Look at his mindset. See, he is a person who is young. He is narrating the story. When he is narrating the story, he is telling, I know my grandmother for 20 years. Right? From the age I had known her, I had seen her old, wrinkled. As a grandmother only, I had seen her. But people all around know, they are telling me, she was once young. She was very pretty. She had a husband also. Very hard to believe. I cannot believe that. He is just telling out his mind. Thought and his mind voice, that's all. My grandmother's portrait, grandfather's portrait hung above the mantelpiece in the drawing room. There is a drawing room where there is a mantelpiece. Mantelpiece, it is given over there. In your glossary, it is there. Glossary is in page number 4. Glossary is in page number 4. You can turn your pages, you can refer the glossary. And now here I have written the glossary over there. Mantelpiece means a projecting shelf. From the wall, a shelf is being projected. That is a mantelpiece. Okay. So above the mantelpiece, what is hanging? grandfather's portrait. Okay, the grandmother's husband. Grandfather's portrait is hanging on the mantelpiece in the drawing room. He wore a big turban. What is it called? Big turban. Okay, big turban. That is the on the head the gents will wear. Okay, big turban and loose fitting clothes. Nowadays we wear all gym kind of t-shirt and all that. Yes, that is what the trending now. Those days, grandfathers will wear all loose fitting pyjamas like that. Okay, so he was wearing a loose fitting clothes. His long white beard covered the best part of his chest. He looked at least 100 years old. So look at that. He is having this grandfather's portrait. No, he is having a big turban. He is wearing a loose fitting cloth. In the photograph itself, he is able to see. He is wearing a loose fitting cloth and his beard. No, it's a white beard that starts from here and covers almost all part of his chest. Such a long beard he is having. And to the author, that grandfather is not actually 100 years old. To the author's mindset, he is telling, my grandfather, no, if I look at the portrait, he is looking like as though he is 100 years old. Okay. He did not look the sort of a person who would have a wife or children. He looked as if he could have only lots and lots of grandchildren. Okay. So he is telling, he is not a person who will have a wife. He is not a person who will have children, but I am sure he will have lots and lots of grandchildren. See, he is having a... Okay, he might not understand, but for his mindset, for his thought, looking at the portrait, he is thinking, grandfathers will have only grandchildren. They will not have wife, they will not have children. That is what his mindset is. He is just pouring out his mindset in the book. As for my grandmother, now he has finished talking about his grandfather. Now he is talking about this grandmother. As for my grandmother, being young and pretty, the thought was almost revolting. People are telling she was young, she was pretty. No, I cannot accept it at all. The thought is completely revolting. I cannot accept it at all. She often told us the games she used to play as a child that seemed quite absurd and undignified on our part, and we treated it like the fables of the prophets she used to tell us. Okay, so grandmother, in your home also, if grandmothers are there, if old people are there, they used to tell you, those days we used to play this, we used to play hide and seek. Will you believe it? Yes, you will believe it because you are in 11th standard. Imagine you are in 3rd standard, 1st standard, the grandfather says you, grandmother says you, we will be playing hide and seek, we will be climbing trees. Will you believe it? You will say, what? Your grandmother, you cannot do. Like that only the author is also thinking on. Okay, the author is also thinking, being a grandmother, that is not dignified on her part. She cannot play games. She cannot go ahead to enjoy. That is absurd, absurd, illogical. That is not at all logical. That is illogical. A grandmother cannot be like this. That is what is the mindset of the author. Okay, and he is treating, right, whenever the grandmother is sharing her experiences, he is treating it like fables, old stories, moral stories, prophet stories, and all your grandmothers will tell you, right? Likewise, the same category only, her own experiences also goes. Like that only the author is treating those stories too. She had always been short, fat, slightly bent. Okay, so this is the physical description of the grandmother. She is short, fat and slightly bent, means the back of the grandmother is not straight as we are having. Okay, it is slightly bent because of age. Her face was crisscross of wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. Her face is full of wrinkles. Wrinkles start from here and ends everywhere. Like that it is full of wrinkles. Now, no, we were certain she had always been as we had known her. So he is not able to accept anything. To him, he is fixing it. My grandmother was never young. She was never pretty. She was never having a husband. She was never playing hide and seek or all silly games. Nothing. She is a grandmother from the time I knew, and she is a grandmother only. She cannot be young or pretty or something. He is rejecting the points of acceptance like she had a young age. She is just rejecting it. She is just fixing to the point that she is a grandmother and she is always a grandmother. Like that, he is fixing himself. Old, so terribly old that could not have grown older and had stayed at the same age for 20 years. So for 20 years, the grandmother is the same age, same old grandmother. She could never have been pretty, but she was always beautiful. See how that touch of that grandchild is coming in now. See, Kushwant Singh is an author who will bring it up. Okay, so he is connecting it now. He is telling, author is not able to accept that the grandmother was pretty and all that, but author is always accepting that though she is old, though she is terribly old, she is the prettiest lady he had seen. She is always pretty because we see our grandmother like that. She is cute, she is pretty. We love her. Like that, the author is also, narrator is also loving her, his grandmother. Okay? She hopped about the house in spotless white, one hand resting on her waist and the other balanced her stool and the other telling the beads of her rosary. Her silver locks were scattered untidily on her pale, puckered face and her lips constantly moved in inaudible prayers. She was beautiful. She was like the winter landscape in the mountains, an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. Okay, so he is describing the overall view of the grandmother. Okay, she is a person who will be hobbling all around the house. Hobbling, what is hobble? Unsteadily walking. If your grandmother is walking, will she walk like a military man? No. If your grandmother is walking, she will walk slowly. Each and every step of hers, she will be very careful in placing her steps. It will be an unsteady walking only. So she was hobbling all around the house and she was wearing a spotless white dress. Not even a single spot you can see in her white dress. And she was having a shawl that is covered all around her head. Okay, and that shawl, you know, if your mother is wearing or your sister is wearing, they will make sure the line of the shawl is perfect, it is correct, it is always in the same position. But if you see your grandmother wearing it, just like that thing to cover her head, like that the grandmother's will wear. Exactly like that she was wearing. Okay, and she was holding, she was having one hand at her hip, okay, to support her bend. Okay, and the other hand she was having a rosary. What is a rosary? A bead chain. Okay, a bead chain, what old people will have when they are chanting, they will just scroll over the beads. Okay, that that can be a kind of count for the chantings, like that. Okay, so this grandmother is in that position. In your book, textbook, there is a picture given how the grandmother looks. Okay, so that is how she was looking. Okay, and her lips were constantly moving. This is a very main point. Her lips were constantly moving out of the prayers. She is chanting prayers within herself that is not audible, that is inaudible prayers, but her lips will be seen constantly moving because she is reciting prayers within herself. Okay, and he is comparing, if a mountain, okay, a big mountain covered with full of snow, how will it look? Pretty, serene. What is serene? Serene means devotion, some kind of peacefulness. Okay, so if you see a mountain that is completely covered with the snow, you will feel that serenity, you will feel the peacefulness in your heart. So when you look at the grandmother, she is giving you a picture like that. She is very in a serene kind of a look, she is there. Okay, and she will be a person who will, who is very beautiful, and she is breathing peace and contentment. So she is having that contentment in life, means fulfillment. I am full, my life is good. That kind of a feeling is there in our life. Continuing, my grandmother and I were good friends. My parents left me with her when they went to live in the city, and we were constantly together. Okay, so he is telling his grandmother and he himself, they both were very good friends. Okay, so the parents of this narrator, they had left the narrator with the grandmother. They had gone to the city to earn good money to bring up a very good life for them. So they are in the city and these two people are in the village. She used to wake me up in the morning, get me ready for the school. She said her morning prayers in the monotonous sing song, which she bathed. While she bathed and rested me in the hope that I would listen and get to know by heart. I listened because I loved her voice, but never bothered to learn it. Look at that. Very, very simple mentality of a child. Again, Narendra is a child over there. Grandmother, every morning the grandmother will wake up the Narendra, make him get ready for the school in the way. She will take him to the bathroom. She will make him bath. When she is making him bath, she will also have some prayers or some song, sing song kind of a prayer, where she will sing it monotonously. Means what? Boringly. Who is getting bored because of that? The narrator is getting bored because of that. But what is the intention of the grandmother? Grandmother thought the narrator will listen to that song every day. Narrator will have it by heart. The narrator will also learn that prayer song. But what did the narrator do? He listened because he loved the grandmother's voice. But he never bothered to take it to heart because he did not like it. That is his choice. But being a child, that is what his mindset was. Okay. And then she would fetch my wooden slate, which she had already washed and plastered with yellow chalk, a tiny earthen inkpot, a red pen, a tie. Okay, tie them all into a bundle and hand it to me. So what will the grandmother do? Every time she will get him ready for the school, she will take a wooden slate. Okay, wooden slate means, you know very well what a slate is. So wooden slate is nothing but, there will be a wooden board where this black painting will be done on it. On the top of that, they will write. Okay, we will have plastic and all that. Those days, they had only wooden plates. Okay, so this wooden plate also, she will not just like that wash and give. She will wash it. She will make sure there is that yellow chalk powder kind of a paste she will make. She will scrub that paste on that board so that it writes smoothly. Okay, and she will also give him a tiny earthen inkpot. What is earthen? Can you tell me what is earthen? Earthenwares available, earthenware plates, earthenware pots. Can you guess it? Find it out. So earthenware is nothing but vessels or things made out of mud. Okay, so earthenwares are those. So earthen inkpot was there, it seems. And a red pen was also there. So both the inkpot and the red pen, she will give it to him. So what will she do? This wooden slate, earthen inkpot and the red pen, she will tie it into a bundle and she will hand it over to him before he goes to the school. Okay, after the breakfast of a thick, stale chapati with a little butter and sugar spread on it, we went to the school. Okay, so what is for breakfast? Thick, stale chapati. Okay, stale chapati. Okay, they are very thin, which is cooked, non-cooked kind of a thing. Okay, thick, stale chapati. And with a little butter and sugar spread on it. That is what for the breakfast. And you should note this point. We went to school. The narrator is saying we. Only two people are living here in the village. One is the grandmother and one is the grandchild. They both are only living together. We went to school, he is stating. Means what? She carried several stale chapatis with her for the village dogs. My grandmother always went to school with me because the school was attached to the temple. Okay, so they both will have that chapati, and she will also carry few other chapatis in hand, because when these both are walking in the road, on the road to go to the school, there will be many stray dogs in the road itself. So she used to feed those dogs also. So we means both the grandmother and the grandchild are going to the school because the school is attached to the temple. So the grandmother will spend her time in the temple while the grandchild is learning in the school. The priest taught us alphabet and the morning prayer while the children sat in the rows on the either side of the veranda singing the alphabet or the prayer in the chorus. My grandmother sat inside reciting the scriptures. So here in the village there is no teacher. Okay, the priest of the temple is the teacher. The priest will teach the children alphabets and and the prayer songs. That is what is there most of the education. So when the priest is teaching all these prayers and alphabets, in the veranda of the temple, the children will be seated on the both the side of the veranda in a corner, like we sit in our school. Okay, when we are writing test or when we are learning, we used to split you in the corridor and we used to split like that only they will sit. And they will recite the alphabets of the songs now along with the priest. When this is happening, what will happen? Inside the temple, the grandmother will be reciting prayers over there. When we had both finished, we would walk back together. This time, the village dogs would meet us at the temple door. They followed us each other for chapati, we threw them. Okay, so what will happen? When they are starting from home and going to the school or temple, the stray dogs will follow them that way. Now, just because they are finishing their school and starting from the temple, stray dogs will start from here until their home. So, the stray dogs enjoyed eating chapati both times, morning as well as the evening. When my parents were comfortably settled in the city, they sent for us. That was the turning point in our friendship. Our friendship, whose friendship? Grandmother and the grandchild. Okay, the friendship between the grandmother and the grandchild had taken a turning point. When the parents, this grandchild's parents are there in the city, right, for earning a good life. Now they are settled very much and now they are asking this grandmother and the grandchild to shift to the city. And that's where the turning point takes place in their friendship. Although we shared the same room, my grandmother no longer came to the school with me. Of course, it's obvious, right? In the city schools, they don't allow grandmothers to accompany, yeah? And the children will have separate classrooms, separate teachers. That is not the same as the village school. So, the grandmother is at the home only. They both are sharing the same room. The grandmother and the grandchild, they are living in the same room only. But still, grandmother is at home. The child is going to the school. I used to go to an English school in a motor bus. There were no dogs in the streets and she took feeding sparrows in the courtyard of our city house. Okay, so he is going to an English school now and he is commuting to school. Commuting means traveling. Okay, so he is commuting to school in a motor bus, the school's bus he is traveling in. So he is having no contact with the grandmother while he is on his way to the school. And here the grandmother is not coming out of the house. Like in village, in the city, there will be no stray dogs to eat the chapati she is throwing. So, now the grandmother has picked up some other hobby. What is that? Feeding the sparrows that is coming in the courtyard of the city house. The city house is having a sit out where the grandmother used to sit and feed the sparrows. As years rolled by, we saw less of each other. For some time, she continued to wake me up, get me ready for the school. When I came back, she would ask me what the teacher had taught me. I would tell her English words and little things of Western science and learning of law of gravity, Archimedes' principle, the world being round, etc. This made her unhappy. Okay, even though there is a slight gap that started between the grandmother and the grandchild, even though she is not accompanying him to the school, what she will do? Like every time, she will only make the grandchild, she will only make him get ready for the school. When he is coming back from the school also, the grandmother will ask, okay, what child, you are going to an English school now. What did you learn? Tell me. Okay, but what is the expectation of the grandmother? Grandmother is expecting that, like in village schools, he will learn all the prayers. He will learn all good things, moral things. Like that only the grandmother's expectation is because grandmother knows only that. Okay. But the grandchild used to say, I learned all English words, I learned all Western science. You know what Western science includes? They include law of gravity, Archimedes' principle. You know what? The world is round and all that. He'll be excited in telling, but what will happen to the grandmother? She will feel very unhappy. occasionally feel unhappy because the child is not learning any moral things in the life. That is what is the grandmother's feeling. She could not help me with my lessons. She did not believe in the things they taught in the English school and was distressed that there was no teaching about God and that scriptures and the scriptures. One day I announced that I were being given music lessons. She said nothing, but her silence meant disapproval. She rarely talked to me after that. Okay, so the grandchild is also understanding. Okay, grandmother is accepting, expecting me to learn more about God and everything, but she is a little upset because I have not taught all that in English school. What did the grandchild plan? Okay, today I will go home, I tell my grandmother, I learnt all music classes and all. He went, he ran to the grandmother and he told, today you know I'm in the class in the school, I learned all music lessons. What was the grandmother's reaction? Same reaction. She was upset, she was unhappy, she did not say any word, which means she did not like or she is not interested in it. That is what is a was a disapproval show. Then when I went up to the university, I was given a room of my own. Look at that. Now the grandchild is not in the school level. He has finished his schooling. He has gone to the university. He's a big grown child. When you are a grown child, after 12th standard, will you share your room with your sister, brother or somebody? No, you will demand bread. I want a separate room. I want separate bed. I want to learn. See, I as though you are learning child, what will you portray? I want to learn all night. I want to sit and learn. I will be burning light night lamps. So just give me privacy. I want to learn more. Like that and all, you portray light. So like that, this grandchild has grown. He has gone to the university. Now he is given a separate a room of his own. The common link of friendship was snapped. Okay, so there is a common link. Though the grandmother is not accompanying to school, not teaching him anything, not able to connect with his studies, there was one link. Means which was, what is that? They both were living in the same room. Now just because he is grown up, he has gone to the university, that small link was also snapped. Snapped means cut. Okay, snapped means cut. Abruptly, all of a sudden it is cut. Okay, so it was snapped. My grandmother accepted her seclusion with resignation. Okay, so what happened? She is a person who is very mature. Okay, she is not like a grandmother who will make a fuss of it, or who will sit and cry and all that. She is also understanding. This is the flow of life. A child will grow, a child will have his own world. We have to give space for that child. Like that, she is also accepting. So she accepted her seclusion. What is seclusion? Seclusion is isolation, being lonely, loneliness. Okay, so she is accepting the seclusion with the resignation. She is just accepting it in her heart. I am no more a grandmother who needs to take care. I have to support. Like that, she is accepting it. She rarely left her spinning wheel to talk to anyone. Okay, so already there is less that she is talking with the grandchild. Now she is having a spinning wheel also. You know what the Gandhiji will spin a wheel to make a yarn. Okay, like that the grandmother is also having a spinning wheel. Okay, she rarely left the spinning wheel. Most of the day she will be spinning the yarn and she rarely speak to anyone. Okay, from the sunrise to sunset she sat by her wheel spinning and reciting prayers. Only in the afternoon she relaxed for a while to feed the sparrows. While she sat in the veranda breaking the bread into little bits, hundreds of little birds collected round her, creating a veritable bedlam of chirping. Some came and perched on her legs, others on her shoulders, some even sat on her head. She smiled but never shooed them away. It used to be the happiest half hour of the day of her. Okay, so what happens? Now that she is in a separate room, she is finding out other things to engage herself. Okay, she almost all over the day she will be spinning the yarn. And when she is the afternoon time comes, she will go to the courtyard. She will start breaking the breadcrumbs for the sparrows to be fed. Okay, when she starts to sit there and when she starts to break the breadcrumbs, grounds itself, most of the sparrows, thousands of sparrows will come. They will all come near her. She will feed all the sparrows. Certain sparrows will prick her legs, will prick her head, shoulders, everywhere. But she will never shoo them away. She will never chase them away. She will just enjoy. She will just smile at them and give them food. And this is the half hour, half an hour of the day that she will enjoy every day in the afternoon. When I decided to go abroad for further studies, now he has completed his university. Okay, means he has completed his degree. For all these years of universities, grandmother spent her days like that on me. Okay, and now he has finished his university study and he is now deciding to go abroad for his further studies. I was sure my grandmother would be upset. I would be away for 5 years and at her age, one could never tell, but my grandmother could. She was not very sentimental. She even came to leave me at the railway station, but did not talk or show any emotion. Look at that. I told you already, she is a person who is mature. She is a person who will understand the world. Okay. So, when the grandchild decided to go to the abroad, she even supported that. Okay. She went to the railway station to bid a farewell, okay, to the grandchild. She did not show any emotion. Okay. Her lips moved in prayer. Her mind was lost in prayer. Her fingers were busy telling the beads of her rosary. Silently, she kissed my forehead. And when I left, I cherished the moist imprint she as perhaps the last sign of my physical contact between us. Look at that. Even the grandchild is not a child who is just like my own life, I will carry on. Why should you care? Why should I carry about you? Not like that. Care about you. Not like that. Grandchild is also feeling it. Okay. The grandchild is also understanding. My grandmother will miss me. My grandmother will be upset. But he also knows that grandmother will accept and support him. Okay. Same way grandmother is also doing. She went to the railway station, she hugged him, she kissed him in the forehead. Okay, and when he was about to leave, he was feeling that moisture, because of the kiss, there is a moisture left in the forehead. He feels happy about it. Okay, and he is also thinking, might be this is the last physical contact between them. Might be because he is thinking it because grandmother is very old and he might come back after 5 years. So, might be the grandmother is there or not, he doesn't know. He is not there. He doesn't want to have a hope or he doesn't want to lose hope. He is not in that situation. He is just thinking. Might be this is the last physical contact between them. That is what he is thinking of. But that was not so. After 5 years, I came back from home, and was met by her at the station. See how lucky he is. When he is coming back after 5 years, still, grandmother is there in the railway station to pick him up. He was feeling very happy about it. She did not look a day older. The day he left, he saw his grandmother chanting prayers, having rosaries, reciting prayers. Okay, she kissed him, and when he came back after 5 years, also the grandmother was still there doing the same thing, and she was never looking a day older. She was as it is. Okay, she still had no time for words. And while she clasped me in her arms, I could hear her reciting of her prayers. Even on the first day of my arrival, her happiest moments were with the sparrows whom she fed longer and credulous looks. Okay? So what happens? She is coming, he is coming back, she again hugs him, she again kisses him, where he is able to hear the recitation of the prayer. Okay, she is reciting prayer within herself and he is able to listen to it. Okay, and even if he is coming back, even if certain people will be there. Okay, you left me for 5 years. Come, sit with me, talk with me, spend your time with me, without understanding that they will have some other commitments, they will have some other appointments to attend on. Without understanding it, certain people will expect it. Yes, certain other people will expect it. Nothing wrong in doing that if you have time. Okay, so. Here, the grandchild is having his own life. The grandmother, even after the grandchild is coming back, she is not expecting him to spend the time with her. She is just allowing him to be in his old world. Even after his arrival, the best time of hers was in the afternoon when she was feeding the sparrows around. So, okay, rebukes. The word over there, rebukes means scoldings. Okay, so So with the frivolous scoldings means, just like that, she used to talk with the sparrows. Okay, hey, come here, like that, just like, eat that, don't be mischievous. Like a few moments of sharing she will have with the sparrows. In the evening, a change came over her. She did not pray. She collected the women of her neighborhood, got an old drum and started to sing. For several hours, she thumped and sang in skins and the dilapidated drum and sang the homecoming of warriors. We had to persuade her to stop to avoid overstraining. That was the first time since I had known her that she did not pray. Listen, this is the very important thing in page number 3, right hand side of your paragraph, last but before paragraph, very important one, note it down. Okay? In the evening, when the days went on after his arrival, one day in the evening, there was a small change in the behavior of the grandmother. What did she do? She collected all the women from the neighborhood. Okay, she asked them all to come to her house. She took a old drum, this tabla kind of a drum. Okay, she took it. She started beating the drum and sing the song of the warrior's homecoming. Okay, when the olden days when people had to go to the war, okay, win the war and come back to home, there will be a victorious song that is being sung in the village. That song she started to sing. Okay, beating the drum, she started to sing. For a long time she had been singing, okay, and until what time she sang, you know, the drum, the skin of the drum got dilapidated, means damaged. The skin of the drum became damaged. That long time she was keeping on singing, okay, and we had to persuade. We means the father, mother, and the grandson. Okay, they are all three of them have to persuade her. Persuade means convince her. Convince her to stop. Do not be over excited. Just be like you. Calm down. Like that, they had to bring her back to normal. Okay, and one other important thing. Narrator is noting down. What is that? From the time he had known her, this is the first time she had stopped praying. Okay. The next morning, she was taken ill. It was a mild fever and the doctor told us that it would go. But my grandmother thought differently. She told us that her end was near. She said that since only a few hours before the close of the last chapter of her life, she had omitted to pray. She was not going to waste any more time talking to us. We protested, but she ignored our protests. She lay peacefully in the bed, praying and telling her beads. Even before we could suspect, her lips stopped moving. Rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. A peaceful pallor spread on her face, and we knew that she was dead. Okay, so the next morning she was very ill. Okay, and the doctor also told, it's a mild fever only, it will go off, don't worry. But she was thinking in a different way. As I very well remember, when a soul is about to leave the world, okay, that soul will know that the soul is going to depart. Soul will know. Might be, if they say we will take it in a different way, but the soul will know that. Okay, likewise, the grandmother is also knowing it. Grandmother is also very sure that she is going to say goodbye to the worldly life. She is going to die. She is knowing it and she is also telling them, no, at the last point of my breath, the last few minutes of my death, I am stopping to pray. That's not bad. That is not good. I have to start praying by now. And these people at the home, they said, no, you need not pray. Take rest. But she ignored them. She started praying. She was having rosary in her head. She was laying in her bed. Okay, and she was reciting prayers. When they were looking at her, all of a sudden, her lips stopped moving out of prayers. The rosary fell down from her lifeless hands and she is dead. Okay, there is a pallor that is spread on her face. Pallor, pale appearance. Okay, once the person is dead, the blood flow will stop. So, the face becomes pale. That pallor, the pale appearance was there on her face and everybody knew that she was dead. We lifted her off the bed and, as it is customary, laid her on the ground and covered her with a red shroud. After a few hours of mourning, we left her alone to make arrangements for our funeral. In the evening, we went to her room with a crude stretcher to take her to the cremated. The sun was setting and lit her room and the veranda with a blaze of golden light. So what happened? As soon as she is dead, they lifted her from the bed and placed her on the floor. That's a ritual, that's a common thing that they follow. So they did that, and they had even given her a shroud, that is red in color. Shroud means nothing but a cloth that will be wrapped around the dead body. Okay, so a red color shroud was given to her. She was kept for the mourning. Okay, the people in the neighborhood will come and mourn and all that. Okay, for the funeral, they were getting ready. They brought a stretcher to take her to the funeral ground. Okay, and that time was the evening time where the sun was glowing mild and the entire room of the grandmother was lit in orange and reddish color, which is spread across the room. How lovely it will look like that, the day was. Okay, and it was like a golden light that is spread across the veranda. We stopped halfway in the courtyard, all over the veranda and in her room, right up where she lay dead and stiff, wrapped in the red shroud. Thousands of sparrows sat scattered on the floor. See, who has come to mourn the death? Okay, from the grandson had started going to an English school, she had developed the habit of feeding the sparrows, thousands and thousands of sparrows. Now, those thousands of sparrows had come to mourn for her death. Okay, they are just scattered all around the courtyard. Okay, when they were lifting the stretcher, when they were walking towards the funeral ground, they stopped all of a sudden, looking at what? Thousands of sparrows just sitting scattered all over the courtyard. Okay, there was no chirping. We felt sorry for the birds, and my mother fetched some bread for them. She broke it into little crumbs, and the way my grandmother used to, and threw it to them. Okay, so they were not chirping at all. The chip, 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 chip noise of the bird was not there. They were all sitting quiet. Thousands, thousands of sparrows were sitting in the courtyard, making no noise. Imagine that. Imagine how breathtaking it will be. Okay, so they were all sitting. What did the mother do? She went inside the room. She picked the breadcrumbs. Like the way the grandmother used to break the breadcrumbs and feed them, she broke the breadcrumbs and threw it to them for eating. Okay, what happened? The sparrows took no notice of the bread. When we carried my grandmother's corpse off, they flew away quietly. Next morning, the sweeper swept the breadcrumbs into the dustbin. Look at that. Not only the human beings have the humanity, even the pets. Okay, every living thing with whom you share that love, with whom you share that care, okay, they will pay it back when you are not there. That is what is crude over there. Thousands and thousands of sparrows came, sat in the courtyard without any noise, just like that they sat. When the breadcrumbs were served also, they did not take it. They did not eat. When they carried the corpse of the grandmother, they just flew away quietly. That is their way of showing love to the grandmother. Okay, they showed it. And the next morning, the sweeper swept the breadcrumbs regularly as usual. Whoever is there or not, life will move on. Life will move on. Whoever is there or not. Okay, so likewise, it is moving on. But still, the love, the care, the affection, the understanding, what you show to someone else, the concern you put on them will always be there and will always travel along with their life. Okay, even if a person is dead 25 years, 30 years before, you will understand, you will remember them, how much love they showered on you, right? And that is what had happened with this grandmother too. So students, you would have understood and you would have got the answer for the question I posted in the beginning. Okay, what is that you are going to carry in life after learning this lesson? Okay, I want that to be written in your classwork also. Like, as I mentioned the classwork, you all know very well that 182 pages, long size, ruled notebook that is being provided in the school only, you will be using it for your classwork. So, you can come to the school, you can collect your textbooks, all subject textbooks and your classwork from the school. okay, and you can start writing your classwork. So when you're writing your classwork, English classwork, make sure date is there, unit you have mentioned, rows, lesson name, author name, everything you should mention at the top. Start writing the glossary. Start writing the glossary from the textbook to the classwork. Okay. Read through the lesson. Once you get the book, you will have plenty of time at home. I'm very sure of that. Do not waste your time. Sit at home. Read through this lesson. Give it quite a good reading. You will enjoy reading. Okay. Give it a good reading. Find out any apart from the glossary, if you have any hard words, mark them. Find the meanings from the dictionary. Because I don't have dictionary, guys. Don't tell me that. Okay. If you don't have a dictionary, you need not buy. Okay, you do not pressure your parents to buy a dictionary. You have online dictionaries too. Make use of those online dictionaries. I use Merriam-Webster from Play Store. You can download that too. Okay, so find the meaning of that word from the dictionary. Write it down so that you will understand the lesson better. Fine. As you know, synonyms and antonyms will be from the post lesson. Okay, synonyms, antonyms will be there. 3-mark question will be there. 11th standard, you will have 3-mark questions. No 2-mark questions, 3-mark questions and 5-mark question from post lesson will be there. Understood? So you have to make sure you are preparing for that. In page number 5, there is one, Roman letter 1, 2 and 3. There are questions. In this Roman letter 1 questions, there are questions like A to G. There are 7 questions over there. You can find out the answer of those questions from the book itself. Okay, you need not write it in the classwork because they are the questions which will support you to know what the lesson is about. More about the lesson you can learn. So you know very well in 10th standard I have taught you how to answer the questions. If it is why, the answer should carry because. If it is what, instead of what, you can substitute the answer and you can continue writing the completing the answer with the words that is there in the question itself. So try to answer it that way. How can you cross check? Have you done it right or wrong? Roman letter 2 and Roman letter 3, 3-mark questions and 5-mark questions. I will type the PDF, I will send it to you for notes. Alright. Through WhatsApp, I will send it to you. When you receive it, copy it as it is. When you are copying it down, check. For the question starting with WH questions, what, when, why, where, how, all these questions, how I have started the answer, how I have justified the rule, okay, describing the answer, how it should go. If it is an yes or no question, how should I start, how should I end the answer, all that I would have clearly followed the rules when I am typing the answers for Roman letter 2 and 3. With that, you can cross check with your Roman letter 1 if you have answered it right or wrong. Understood? So, Roman letter 2 and Roman letter 3, I will send you the PDF. Copy the PDF notes in your classwork notebook. 192 pages, long size, ruled notebook. Miss, should I spread it as prose and poetry? Miss, should I spread the classwork into grammar? That, miss, no. You just write it as unit wise. Unit 1, prose. Once you finish prose, next page itself, unit 1, poetry. Like that, you can go ahead. Understood? So, notes will be sent. You should take the material that is provided in the school, write down the notes, submit your material to the school by Friday. Okay, by Friday before 12 o'clock. Before 12 noon, you should be submitting the notes. Understood? Thank you, children. Meet you again.